Now, this is a story about a group of kids who wouldn't obey their teacher. Now, listen to this. I'ma tell you the truth. I ain't no liar. Here's how we made the show called The Forest Fire. In Carolina Forest is where it begins. We had a simple assignment, but we didn't listen. We had to make a show, but we was relaxing all cool and shooting some b-ball outside of the school, when a couple of girls who were in our class said they wanted to make the show so they could all pass. Then in walked the teacher. Her name is Miss Jones. She said if we don't make a show, we'd all get zeros. So we pulled up to school. It was a brand new day. Anchors, interviews, and weather all knew what to say. Everybody came together in the studio, and that's how we made this fantastic show, The Forest Fire.
The Forest Fire.
Hey, hey, hey.
Welcome to The Forest Fire. It's March 21st. I'm Kyle.
And I'm Sade. Let's see what's going on in Academic and Bucks. That's all for your Academic Inbox.
Now let's pass it over to Alex with our CF weather.
What's up, Panthers? It's Alex here with your weather forecast. It's sunny out here right now, and it's going to be sunny all weekend. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Alex.
Let's pass it over to Mary, who interviewed Ms. McDowell about Anchor Club.
Thanks, Kyle and Shade. I'm here with Ms. McDowell talking about Anchor Club. So what is Anchor Club?
Anchor Club is a civic organization that anyone with any background can participate in here at Carolina Forest High School.
And how can you join?
Basically, we have open membership usually the entire month of August and part of September, and you have to pay a fee to join because you're also affiliated with Pilots International, and then you're a member throughout the year, and we just participate in several community activities.
And what are your plans for the future?
Our next plan, our really big event coming up, is Earth Day. We plan on going out and helping Ocean Bay Middle School and Ocean Bay Elementary School kind of have a tent set up to help little children learn how to plant seeds.
Great. Thanks. Back to you guys in the studio.
What a great interview, Mary.
Now let's pass it over to Troy and Ashley for our sports report.
But first, we have a PSA on motivation.
I'm gonna breathe when the weight is on my chest. And I'm gonna scream when there are no words left. I'm gonna dig deep to find the strength that I possess because I believe these roadblocks are not dead ends. I will jump the roadblocks to chase what I'm after. And should I trip in pursuit, I'm gonna block out the laughter because those who laugh are trying to justify their complacency, trying to slow down the race because they can't keep the pace with me. The end's in sight and I'm running. Muscles burning, fueled by yearning, hopes of earning a place discerning eyes can't degrade in an industry built by leaps of faith. I'll get there, but today's today. and I'll fight its battles using adversity to motivate.
What's up, guys? I'm Troy.
And I'm Ashley.
Welcome to your Forest Fire Sports. Let's take a look at the sports inbox.
That's all for your sports inbox.
Now let's pass it over to Allie, who interviewed Maddie Ernest about girls' soccer.
Hi guys, I'm here with Maddie Ernest, a varsity soccer player. So Maddie, you're a freshman and you're playing varsity. How is varsity different from JV?
It's just more competition and a little more serious.
What's you guys' record so far in the season this year?
We've won 2 games against North Myrtle Beach and Sumter.
You guys have a game tonight against Sauk City. How do you guys think that's going to pan out?
I think it's going to go really good as long as we just try our best.
Well, good luck tonight, and back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks for that wonderful interview, Allie. That's it for your Forest Fire Sports.
Now let's pass it back to Kyle and Sade.
That's all for the Forest Fire.
And have a frat Friday.